Major General GD Bakshi joining us on the broadcast right now. GD Bakshi, good morning to you. It's a big boost for the Make in India defense sector, with the Indian Army right now getting its first 12 indigenously developed 10-meter short span bridging systems. How will this help India's fight ahead?
Excellent. This is excellent news. And the last of the Cubra that have made this system have been doing great work in quad with our DRDO and other organizations. This bridge will very greatly, enhance our mobility in the plains, semi-desert sectors, also in the deserts where we have to cross canals, we have to cross small streams as we go ahead in our advance into enemy territory. So these quick bridges, they save a lot of time because they are deployed very quickly and they enable armored columns to move with great speed and go deep into enemy territory and cause the collapse of his psychological setup, because by the very speed of your advance,
right,
you can unhinge the enemy.
Major General Bakshi, thank you for joining us this morning on the broadcast. On the broadcast, I'm also joined by Major General A.K. Sivaj. Mr. Sivaj, good morning to you. We're looking at a big strides here the Indian defense sector is making with 12 indigenously developed 10-meter short-span bridging systems having been inducted today. India is stressing on its defense modernization at this point of time, even though we are in a COVID situation. How do you view the developments in the Indian Army at this point of time?
Absolutely, Kaisi. It is a very good development. Fact is that we have now indigenously developed this 10-meter span bridge, which will be a force multiplier for Indian Army. Remember that, especially in the western sector, the terrain is ridden with number of river nalas and streams, and you need to cross over at the earliest. When you have indigenous built these bridges, they can be lost at the earliest because they have a matching speed with the mechanized column, and then you can cross over, and then the troops can cross over, so is the tanks and so is the other vehicle. So this is a game changer, it's a force multiplier, and the main issue of this is that it's indigenously built. We were spending so much money buying Russian as well as European equipment. Now we have a capability of manufacturing within our country. That is what it makes a difference. A 10-meter span, a bridge which is being built, is going to make a lot of difference in time to come. So I feel that, that during even COVID time, if this development was taking place, it is a matter of encouragement for all of us, and it is a game changer. In future war, you need a mechanized column to have the same speed, and also your bridging column and logistic column. So if you want that, then you're able to launch a bridge at the earliest, and nothing can be better than that, a 10-meter span, a bridge which can be launched at the earliest within about an hour or half an hour. That will make sure that your all columns have matching speed, and you can make a dent in the western sector. So I suppose this is a very good beginning, and it is a boost in making India an Atmanirbhar concept. And remember, otherwise we were spending so much money buying items from Russia, especially majority of this bridging equipment were bought. And second thing, they have become obsolete. Now you need a modern technology. So DRDO is now matched the modern technology as well as the Indian requirement. So 10-meter span, 12 bridges, which is handed over, a step in the right direction, and suppose the DRDO will manufacture many more such things, wherein unnecessarily we have to spend money in buying from the foreign vendors.
Major General A.K. Sivaj, thank you for joining us on the broadcast. Right now we have Colonel Rohit Dev also joining us. Colonel Rohit, my question to you is, how do you view the latest developments in the Indian Army? Are we becoming on course to become a superpower in the defense sector? Encouraging news coming in right now that Make in India has got a big push with 12 indigenously developed 10-meter short span bridging systems having been inducted.
I would like to say a couple of points. 10-meter span is tactically pertinent and important bridge, which we have been trying to ask for a long time in our country. One has been part of the mechanized forces for a long time. And this bridge is not only oriented towards operations only in Pakistan, but I'm quite sure it will have the kind of air portability and utilization avenues also along the rivulets and such crossing obstacles, even in other theaters, including the LSE, where we had a large induction of mechanized forces after the Galwan incident. Also, it's a very big push in terms of Atmanirbhar Bharat, as I understand, because not only the user, the Army, you know, Infrastructure of Engineers has gone to the DGMO and made this demand, the R&D component of the DRDO has been actively involved, and the curation of this bridge has been through L&T, again, through the indigenous route. So the Atmanirbhar dream is getting a push. And as one sees the last 7-8 years of what is being pushed into the defense sector right from the time of late Sri Parikar, one finds that in each aspect, whether we develop Dhanush or any other gun system or even many other defense components over the last 7-8 years, but the push has been to drive the defense sector into the indigenous mode. You also having the defense corridor coming up in India, along with we'll have a lot of industrial manufacturing sector coming up to support the sector. So I think all in all, it's a very good progress. And this bridge, while it is a tactical equipment, it has got currently operational and even strategic ramifications in so far as those areas where India has to induct reserves to react to even China is concerned is important. So no doubt it's something which is designed oriented towards Pakistan, but I am quite sure it's a very, you know, versatile asset which will come in handy for operations, and these first 12 bridges should be the hallmark given to the armored divisions probably to take their efforts ahead. And let's see how it goes in terms of more construction. And I'm so happy that after a long time, these small changes, if I may say, are going to robustly, you know, shape our destiny in terms of becoming a military power. Because unless you produce yourself, unless the technology is your own, and if you're dependent only on imports to a large degree, you will not succeed. I'll give you one more example. Arjun tank, which came in with nearly 90% of its import, except the, you know, metal part in India, today is mostly an indigenous tank with very key components coming from outside.
Right.
So if you scale up the requirement there, you will again have a fillip. So these small things, I'm so glad that this equipment has been made during the COVID times. People have put their effort. Kudos to DRDO, L&T, and the Corps of Engineers who have curated this. And kudos to the DGM of the Indian Armed Forces to be having that metal to carry on pushing the indigenous drive. So that's from my side. Thank you, and I think it's a good move.
Thank you so much, Colonel Rohit, for joining us this morning. Also joining us has been Commander Praful Bakshi. Praful Bakshi, sir, what is your message to the Indian Armed Forces as they induct 12 indigenous systems today?
It's absolutely congratulatory. Let me tell you one thing. No bridge in the tank. Bridge laying equipment has been there. We have been acquiring it from outside. We have been working on it for a long time. But now when we have an indigenously produced BLT, you know, if when the bridge laying equipment is carried on the vehicle, the first thing is the maneuverability of the equipment is increased. And then, you know, whenever there are ditches, rivers, rivulets, everything, our army does not have to stop. Even in the territories like Siachen, in Galwan area, there are a number of times when our troops get halted due to this, and they have to put a lot of time, you know, building it across. This is where this equipment will come very handy to increase the speed of the advance in the tactical battle area. But not only battlefield, this army has been being involved in the humanitarian task a number of times, and you see the army will be called now more often whenever there is a problem, a calamity, etc. This, of course, will be used, but it's being used in the increasing the fighting efficiency is absolutely exceptional. Not only this, whenever the ground units of Air Force, etc. move, we'll have this equipment also be placed there when our tactical radars move in uneven ground. They also take help of it. Not only army, especially the missile unit, they also will be taking help of this. So this is all around equipment, and it will help the Indian Armed Forces, especially in the tactical battle area, and now integrated fighting forces which are coming up. This will be a main equipment in every integrated look.
Thank you, Mr. Praful Bakshi, for joining us this morning. Certainly a big boost for Make in India in the defense sector.